Hello friends, welcome to the lecture series on computer communication networks. In this particular video series, we will be discussing next part of module 2, that is wired local area networks, in other words Ethernet. Myself Abhilash KJ, assistant professor, department of electronics and communication engineering, will take you guys through the session. So, we previously have considered the functioning of data link layer. We discussed the responsibilities of data link layer. Also, we considered in case of the multi-point network or the broadcast scenario, the need for media access control and the way of implementing media access control in terms of different protocols. Now, we have to extend our discussion to the next part, that is application of the data link layer. So first, we'll consider the wired local area networks, then we'll consider wireless local area networks. So in this particular video lecture, we'll consider wired local area network, that is Ethernet. We consider the background of the discussion, then we consider the Ethernet protocol, then we consider IEEE project 802, that is a standard for Ethernet. Then finally we'll consider the evolution of the Ethernet in the different phases. As usual, we have considered the textbook Data Communication and Networking by Frozen, 5th edition, for this particular video. So coming to the background for wired local area networks or Ethernet, as I have already mentioned, we have discussed the different responsibilities of data link layer, the issues related to data link layer, the way of implementing the different scenarios in terms of point-to-point network or multi-point network, what are the challenges that is involved in individual cases. We discussed in the previous module. Now we extend the discussions we had in data link layer to the next level in terms of its application. So specifically taking an example of local area networks. So first we consider wired local area networks in this first part of the second module, and later in the third module we'll consider wireless local area networks. So in wired local area networks, there were many protocols that has been proposed and they are existed, but over the time, it is only the Ethernet protocol that has survived over the years. So we shall discuss the following concepts in relation with wired LAN or the Ethernet. If we consider Ethernet protocol and its evolution, we consider standard Ethernet, and we consider next the fast Ethernet, and then we consider gigabit Ethernet, and finally we'll consider the 10 gigabit Ethernet at the later part of this particular video series. So coming to the Ethernet protocol, as we have already mentioned or we have discussed in the first module, the TCP/IP protocol suite or the OSI protocol suite does not specify or does not define a specific protocol for data link layer or the physical layer. In other words, what exactly it means is that the TCP/IP protocol suite accepts any protocol at these two individual layers, that is data link layer as well as the physical layer, which can provide services to the network layer. As we have already considered, it is a responsibility of the lower layer is to provide the services that is requested from the higher layer. So the physical layer and the data link layer can use any of the protocol such that it provides services for the next higher layer, that is your network layer. So the data link layer and the physical layer typically mentions and territory of local and wide area networks. So the term here, the territory means that, so local area networks are predominantly discussed or defined for a geographical area of a smaller size, and wide area network is nothing but larger than that of the local area network. But when the communication is beyond the network, we go for network layer. Thus, the applicability of data link layer and the physical layer is implemented well in local and wide area networks. So thus, whenever we are discussing these two layers, we are indirectly speaking about the networks that are using them. So the local area network is nothing but the computer network that is specifically designed for a limited geographical area, such as a building or the campus. Sometimes it can be considered as an isolated network to connect the computers in an organization for the major purpose of sharing the resources. So since we have a large in the case of large organizations, there is a requirement of a large number of resources. Instead of providing the large number of resources for everybody, if we can establish or provide, develop an environment wherein one can share the resources of others, so the local area network is means of implementing. So in 1980s and 90s, there were different kinds of local area networks that were proposed, which were implemented by making use of media access method. Since the local area network make use of a shared common medium in this particular scenario, it is a multipoint or a broadcast network. So the examples including the Ethernet used CSMA bar CD approach, that is carrier sense multiple access with collision detection, the token ring and token bus, and FDDI, that is fiber distribution data interfaced, made use of token passing approach, that is one of the controlled access scheme we considered earlier. So during this particular time period, that is in 80s and 90s, there is one more LAN technology which came into picture, which revolutionized the concept of internet, that is ATM LAN. ATM stands for asynchronous transfer mode, which is usually deployed in order to facilitate the high-speed wide area network technology that appeared in the market, which completely changed the perspective of looking into a LAN network. So over the years, even though there were multiple Ethernet protocols that are proposed, that could not survive in the market because of the different parameters. So as the years passed by, the user's requirement also changed with respect to time, in terms of speed, in terms of capacity, in terms of the duration for which the distance for which the communication could be established. So many of the protocols which were proposed for Ethernet protocol could not survive or meet the expectations of an individual or an organization or a campus in this particular regard. But Ethernet was able to update itself to meet the needs of individual users over the time. So basically, in terms of the capacity or the speed that was given in each individual case. As in day-to-day life, if we consider, so speed of internet each individual day is increasing. So then as per the needs of the user. So similarly, in this particular case, so Ethernet was only one such protocol which survived this expectation from the user in terms of the higher transmission rates. So in this particular video series, we confine our discussion of wired local area networks with respect to only the Ethernet protocol. So before discussing what exactly is Ethernet protocol, and its all the generation and its specification, we have to discuss first an standard that is been developed by an international body. So in 1985, the Computer Society of IEEE started a project referred as Project 802, which was designed in order to enable the intercommunication among the different equipments from variety of manufacturers. So even though the term setting up of the standard is being told, it doesn't mean that the Project 802 didn't do any changes or it didn't replace the any part of the OSI model or the TCP/IP protocol suite. Instead, they specified the functions of the physical layer as well as the data link layer in order to apply them for the LAN networks in terms of the LAN protocols. So this specifies the relationship between the OSI or TCP/IP suite with IEEE standard that was proposed. As we can clearly see here, on left part of the screen, we have the data link layer and the physical layer and the transmission media or the physical media we are taking into consideration in terms of OSI or TCP/IP suite. So on the right hand side, the IEEE Project 802 specified an individual responsibilities of the physical layer as well as the data link layer. So one of the main thing which we have to consider here is the physical layer. We have for each kind of the Ethernet technologies that came into picture or Ethernet protocol that came into picture, there was a different functionality that was defined. For Ethernet physical layer, it is different. For token ring networks and local area networks, it is different. For token bus local area network, it is different. At the same time, other part we have to discuss or mention in this particular scenario is that we have previously discussed in data link layer, in case of the broadcast media or the multipoint network scenario, the functionality of data link layer could be split into two sub layers. One is logical link control and other one is media access control. The function of logical link control is framing, error control, flow control. At the same time, the responsibility of media access control, that is MAC sublayer, is to facilitate the process of accessing the medium. Since we are speaking of a shared broadcast medium, it has to specify who can access the medium, for how long he can access the medium, and dependent on what parameter he is allowed to access the medium. All those conditions which are defined by the MAC sublayer. As we have previously considered in MAC sublayer, the responsibilities in terms of different access protocols we have considered in terms of either in terms of random access protocols, controlled access protocols. It can facilitate any of the operations dependent on the channelization techniques. So dependent on the multiple access methods, it implements the MAC layer, sublayer usually implements the functionality for accessing the medium. So since local area network is also such a broadcast medium or multipoint network scenario we are speaking of, there will be two sublayers, that is logical link control and the media access control. Let us look into the responsibilities of each with respect to IEEE Project 802. Consider logical link control layer, sublayer. Here, in IEEE Project 802, the flow control, error control, and a part of framing duties will be implemented by logical link control layer. And the framing here, one has to remember here, the part of the framing here means the framing is handled both by the logical link control sublayer as well as the MAC sublayers. So usually LLC, that is logical link control, provides a single layer control protocol for all the IEEE LANs. If you remember the last diagram we considered, so logical link control was common for all kinds of the local area networks we have considered, but the media access scheme was control layer sublayer was different for each of the protocols. So here it provides the interconnectivity between the different local area networks because it makes MAC sublayer as a transparent sublayer. So next, considering media access control, the responsibilities in terms of IEEE project 802, it implements the multiple access methods in terms of random access, controlled access, or the channelization. So here the media access control that defines the specific access method for each of the line. That is why we had separate blocks. So if you are considering Ethernet, CSMA bar CD is the media access method that is being used for Ethernet. And the token passing method is used for token ring as well as a token bus local area networks. So as we have considered additional to media access control, the other responsibility that is being given to the media access control is in terms of the part of the framing function, which is handled by the MAC sublayer. So next we'll consider the evolution of Ethernet over the years. As I have clearly mentioned, it was a standard Ethernet initially we had. Over the period, dependent on the institutional or organizational or individual requirements, there is an adaptability or upgradation is done for the basic standard Ethernet. So which usually in terms of the demand for the higher transmission rates. So there are four such generations which are considered, which we'll study in this particular module. First one is a standard Ethernet, which provided an transmission speed of or transmission rate of 10 Mbps. Then over the years, the second version of Ethernet came into picture, which is referred as fast Ethernet, which gave the speed of the increased speed of 100 Mbps. Then the next version of the Ethernet, which is considered as gigabit Ethernet, which provided a speed maximum transmission rate of 1 Gbps, that is 1 gigabits per second. Then the current version, that is higher version of gigabit Ethernet, which is considered as 10 gigabit Ethernet, which gives or supports the transmission rates up to 10 gigabits per second. So this is about the Ethernet evolution. So in this particular module, we'll first consider the standard Ethernet, the issues addressed in standard Ethernet and specifications of standard Ethernet. Then we extend once we know the standard, understood the concepts of standard Ethernet, then we will consider what changes has been incorporated in standard Ethernet in order to get the upgradation in terms of the fast Ethernet, gigabit Ethernet and the 10 gigabit Ethernet. So about this particular video, here we have considered the applicability of the media access control schemes and the data link layer issues we have considered. We discussed the outlines of Ethernet protocol and IEEE project 802 and the evaluation of Ethernet. So in next lecture, we'll consider the factors related to the standard Ethernet or the issues related to the standard Ethernet in detail. Thank you.